Well, Cameron, police say they got a lot of tips right after the crash, and that helped them zero in on this suspect right away. And now the charges show that they believe this was a case of drinking and driving. Two felonies and a misdemeanor for driving with a suspended license. That's what 24-year-old Caitlin Slater faces after turning herself in Friday morning. She's charged in the death of 19-year-old Trevor Pro, who was hit while walking on the side of Highway 421 near the Peace Haven Road exit in Winston-Salem around 3 a.m. on Saturday, February 19th.
We approach motor vehicle deaths where alcohol is a factor as a homicide case. That's how we approach it.
Slater's charged with felony hit and run, and the most serious charge is aggravated felony death by motor vehicle. Forsyth County District Attorney Jim O'Neill explains the conditions that need to exist for such a charge.
You have to be able to prove that the driver was intoxicated, they unintentionally killed another person, and within the last 7 years, they have been convicted of a DWI.
We look through Slater's arrest record, which shows she was convicted of DWI and had her license taken away in June of 2009. But how was she charged with being intoxicated even though she didn't take a breathalyzer test at the scene? Winston-Salem Police Sergeant Robert Peterson says in investigations like this, the police piece together where the suspect went and what she did.
We've drawn a timeline from the beginning of the day till the end when we were called out.
In court papers, the prosecution says not only did Slater leave the scene of the accident here on Highway 421, but she also asked people that she knew to help hide her damaged car. Slater is the daughter of a retired Winston-Salem police officer. She could face between 5 and 6 years in prison on the aggravated felony charge and 19 months on the hit-and-run charge. Slater's birthday is February 18th, and her friends tell us that she went out and celebrated her birthday that night, which was a Friday night, and the accident happened in the early morning hours of the 19th. We're live in Winston-Salem. Craig Thomas, WXII 12.